How far would you go for love? If you're a Western gray whale, you might go a whopping 14,000 miles. Hey everyone, Julia here for DNews. Many animals migrate. Birds, fish, reptiles, mammals all do it. Lots of animals travel to greener pastures to mate or feed. But by far and away, the most common reason is to get the hell away from winter. I feel you, animals. Most migrations are to areas of warmer climates for the winter and back north again for the summer. Not unlike your snowboard grandparents, animals are willing to go pretty far for fairer weather. A recent study published in the journal Biology Letters made quite a splash. A team of researchers from the US and Russia tracked a western gray whale for a while. I mean, a while. This whale, Barbara, started from Russia's Sakhalin Island, where their feeding grounds are, and journeyed across the Pacific Ocean, down the west coast of the United States, all the way to their breeding grounds off the coast of Baja, Mexico. The total mileage she racked up, she swam right into the record books at almost 14,000 miles round trip, making it the longest mammal migration ever recorded. But she's not the only one willing to go the distance. Caribou, also called reindeer, are found across the northern regions of North America, Europe, and Asia. Some herds are really, really big. The porcupine caribou herd is 169,000 animals large. In the spring, as the cold Arctic tundras thaw, the caribou journey far northward to feed on newly exposed grasses and plants. And as the cold sets back in, they head back down south to chow on lichens. The journey can take as many as 1,600 miles each way, making it the longest land migration for mammals. No talk about migrations is complete without mentioning the monarch butterfly. The eastern population can fly over 3,000 miles to spend the winter in warmer weather in Mexico. Some can fly up to 50 miles a day. Yet their population is in decline, mostly due to habitat destruction and changes in climate. They use a process called time-compensated sun navigation to find their way. Basically, they use the position of the sun and the time of the day as tools to keep them going in the right direction throughout their long trip. It may come as no surprise, but birds fly the farthest. The award for one of the longest bird migrations ever goes to the tiny Arctic tern. It took a while for scientists to figure this one out. Previously, the award went to a bigger bird, the sooty shearwater, who topped out at a 40,000-mile trip. But as technology allowed for smaller tracking devices, researchers turned to ever smaller birds. The Arctic tern's long journey starts in Greenland, and every year, after a little zigzagging around, the bird winds up 44,000 miles away in Antarctica. Another recent study published in the journal Biology Letters found one of the longest nonstop flights for any bird. The Black Pole Warbler flies over 1,500 miles in one fell swoop. Over 2 or 3 days, the songbird flies from the forests of New England and Canada and heads to the Caribbean for the winter. To prep for the long trip, a bird might pack on an extra 5 or 6 grams of fat. While bigger birds like the northern wheatear fly a little farther, a researcher from York University, not involved in the study, told Newsweek that it's more impressive that so small a bird like the Black Pole Warbler can make it so far. The longest nonstop flight of all time, however, goes to the Alaskan bar-tailed godwit. Over 8 days, the bird will travel from Alaska to New Zealand, an almost 7,000-mile trip with no breaks. So how do birds travel so far? How do they know where they're going? While they are somehow able to sense the Earth's magnetic field, researchers aren't sure. Some researchers from the University of Oxford think that a magnetically sensitive protein called cryptochrome that regulates circadian rhythms might be responsible. As blue or green lights hit atoms in the protein, it makes electrons spin in response to magnetic fields. Weird, right? All right, want any more answers for your animal questions? Let us know down in the comments below. While you're at it, don't forget to hit those like and subscribe buttons and keep coming back here. We've got new episodes every day of the week.